dance. Ha ha! Aquí, hijo, en Unión Americana, en Los Ángeles, Chicago, Atlanta, en New York. Actions speak louder. It's true. And music is action made loud. Or better, music is a form of social action. And that's what I want to talk to you about today. I want to talk to you about music as a form of social action precisely in the context of our contemporary world, precisely in the context of economic globalization and the asymmetries of economic globalization, the fractures of economic globalization, the social asymmetries, the cultural asymmetries, and the economic asymmetries. I want to talk about music as a social action in the context of a world that, as the UN has recently reported, contains over 213 million migrants, 213 million people who have been forced to leave their homes, refugees, exiles, and immigrants. Staying at home in this world has become a lot harder to do. But the more people that move, the more millions that move around the world, the more that the world is bordered and partitioned. And the new proliferation of militarized borders and partitions across the world tend to operate according to this map here that Thomas Barnett, a former strategist for the Pentagon, outlines for us. That there is a political equator, he says, that separates one part of the world from the other. The functioning core on the one hand and the non-integrating gap on the other. On the one hand, a world that is full of money, full of motion and freedom, full of profit and information and assets, and another part of the world that is not. And militarized borders are designed to keep those worlds apart. What I'm interested in, though, is what this political equator sounds like. And I want to urge us all today to start listening to borders, to start listening not at the centers of the world, but at the edges of the world. And to think about what we learn when we listen at the edges, but also what we learn when we listen for the edges. In our daily listening practices, in the music that we make, what if we are consciously not listening for centers, but we are listening for edges, listening for borders? And the border that I want to talk about specifically today is the one that is making us all possible in this room right now. The U.S. Mexico border, the 2,000 mile long line that allows us to say that we are in Los Angeles, California, USA. It's the geopolitical borderline that structures our very identity, our very sightedness in this room. But when people talk about the U.S.-Mexico border, like most borders, we usually think of them as visual things. We think of borders as lines on maps. We think of borders as walls, as fences, or as monuments. But we also need to think about borders as things that make sound, that make noise. We need to listen for them as sonic constructions as well. Ever since the border was created in 1848 to end the Mexican-American War, most government versions of how borders work have borders functioning as forces of silence, forces that destroy narrative and kill storytelling. But in fact, the opposite has been true. Ever since the border existed, the border has been something, a wall, a fence, a line that speaks and sings and shouts. The border has never been quiet. And many people over the years have actually worked hard to try to figure out how to make the border come to life as sound. So you have sound artists like Richard Lerman in Arizona who constructs razor wire microphones that he attaches to border fences and border walls to make walls and fences actually release their acoustic properties. And then he does performances at the border itself. where he teaches border residents how to actually turn borders into sites of performances. He tells them to try to go through the fence, to strike the fence with a mallet. He even teaches residents how to play the fence with a passport, to turn the border into an instrument. And this is also what Glenn Wyant, also in Arizona, does. It's part of his project called Sonic Anta, which you'll be hearing in the background. He goes a step farther and he actually takes a cello bow and he bows the border wall. He bows the border fence. He turns border walls into what he calls deterritorialized border cellos. But by far, the people who have been making the border turn into sound and into music the most over the years have been all of the many musicians across Mexico and across the US who make music about migration, norteño musicians, musicians who play banda music and cumbia. And it's through regional Mexican music, as we call it here in the United States, that the dominant ways that the border is turned into a set of stories, stories about migrants, about migrant life, have been told.
Desafiando fronteras, defendiendo el honor. He pasado la vida explorando otras tierras para darle a mis hijos un mañana mejor.
Like an eagle in flight, they sing. Challenging borders, crossing borders, and moving to new lands to find a better life for my children. But there's also the work of the sonideros, or the sonidos, the Mexican sound systems that exist, the big mobile DJ systems that exist throughout Mexico and throughout the United States. Sonideros, literally the sound men who create big sound systems, mobile DJ systems that they take on the road throughout Mexico and throughout the US and use these big kind of typical sound system setups of stacks of amplifiers and speakers. But for them, amplification is not just about sonic volume, which is important, but it's about the amplification of politics, the amplification of migrant politics and migrant messages through music. So if you go to a sonidero party, you'll hear this.
Para Rigo. Para Ruby. Grupo Cocoy de Chololita la Bella. Rigo es amor.
Now you might have noticed that you can dance to that, but you're also having to listen to a lot of shout outs. So what happens at sonidero parties is actually people come as much to dance as they do to deliver messages, dedications and shout outs. And usually it's dedications and shout outs to friends and family who are not there physically. Either it's friends and family who you've left behind or friends and family who you've lost. And the goal at the sonidero party is to give your message to the sonidero so he can shout and speak in as loud a voice as possible your messages so that after the party, they then burn the DJ mix from the party onto a CD and you take that CD and you send it home to your family so that the messages of migration are the DJ mix and vice versa. And the whole goal of the sonidero party is to actually create these transnational messaging events. And the way that sonideros do this is they use the crossfader of the mixing board. And the crossfader, those of you who've ever used a mixing board know, moves between two key channels. One source of musical information on the left channel, another source on the right channel. And with the toggle of the crossfader, you juggle between the two musical sources. But what sonideros do is they're not just juggling sound. They're juggling identities. They're juggling homelands. And the art of the crossfade is to find that sweet spot in the middle where the two channels can coexist so that the border becomes not a source of separation, but a source of innovation and new ideas, a new mix that's born in the space of the crossfade. So when crossfading happens, it's happening through the mix of sound, the mix of space, and the mix of time. And I want to end by saying that what sonideros do and what this new politics of migrant listening should do is embrace the space of the allá. In Spanish, aquí is this space right here that I can see all of you. The allí is the space just back there that I can still kind of see, but it's not right in front of me. But allá is the space that is outside of this room. The allá is this over there space that I know, I pretty much believe is there. And I need to find a way to get there. Sonideros make music that embraces what I call the aesthetics of allá. And this is music that bridges all kinds of distances, geographic and physical ones. It's music that creates a space of complete connection between Mexico and the United States. It's music that crossfades homelands and allows separate homelands to live in the same space. It's music that helps you recover from loss. It's music that allows you to mourn, that makes the absent present. And most importantly, the aesthetics of allá are about having us lead lives that are geared and tuned to getting to that place over there, that space just beyond what we can see, that we know is there, and we have to work so hard to find our way to actually arrive. Because once we arrive, that is what the mix can do. Allá is a space that we all have on the horizon that we need to find a way to finally get to and make a new political future out of it. Thank you so much.